Hello YouTube, welcome to my first video on the topic of structured products. I'm looking at my screen right now and I can see that I probably need to adjust the lights a little bit because I look like a floating head, but we'll continue on anyhow. I'm sure it'll be fine and hopefully it doesn't scare anyone too much. So today's video is on the topic of structured products, and what we're going to do is we're going to learn about the basics of structured products, so what they are, how they're structured, who buys them, and why. Okay, so today we're going to learn all about structured products. I'll make a few videos on this topic and put them all together as a playlist. So unless you're watching it on the first day it's released, hopefully you'll be able to see a linked playlist above on the whole playlist on this topic. But anyhow, firstly, what is a structured product? A structured product, also called a structured note, is an investment product usually made up of a bond and one or more derivatives. The purpose of structured products is to provide an investment payoff that's attractive to investors and that's differentiated from returns available in simple equity or fixed income markets. Now, I've watched a few of the other videos that are up here on YouTube on the topic of structured products, and they're kind of interesting because some of them are by the people who issue structured products, and they'll just tell you they're wonderful products and you should buy them from their bank, and they provide all sorts of amazing investment opportunities to you. A lot of the other videos are put up by market practitioners, people a little bit like me, and they tell you all of the horrors of structured products and how you should entirely avoid them because they're overpriced and a bunch of different reasons. And I guess the purpose of my video is, instead of doing either of those things, I'll tell you just how they work and, you know, why they're there. And we will talk a little bit about it and, you know, I'll explain why maybe I wouldn't necessarily invest in them. But it is a big business for banks. It's a big business in finance. And so a lot of people do want to invest in them and a lot of people want to structure them because it's quite profitable to do so. So anyhow, let's talk a little bit about it. So by combining a bond with, for example, a call option, investors are able to receive bond-like minimum returns with potential for upside payoffs that aren't available from a standard bond. And so in a funny way, a lot of the people who criticize them, like I would look at a product like this and I'd say, well, why would I possibly buy a bond and a call option as a package when I could just buy them as separate products? But of course, these things aren't aimed at me. I'm 20 years of financial experience and manage a hedge fund and things like that. So it's not a product that's pitched at someone like me. It's pitched at retail investors who really can't get those kind of products in any other way. So structured products are, in theory, any investment product that requires tailoring or structuring, as it's known, to provide a specific risk exposure to suit customers' needs. Now, the possibilities for what meets this criteria is obviously enormous. Structured products provide a means for investment banks to issue debt for themselves or other companies at lower than market interest rates. So before the existence of structured products, like we're talking about in this video, one of the only means of issuing sub-market coupon bonds was by issuing convertible bonds, which are in fact also a hybrid security, which means just part bond and part option-like security. Adding option-like features to simple bonds allows banks to give investors something in exchange for a lower interest rate on debt. Structured products are generally difficult for unsophisticated investors to value, but offer unique and sometimes quite attractive payoff profiles, and thus investment banks added high markups to these products and they quickly became very profitable for the issuers. So that probably tells you an awful lot of what you need to know about them. They do provide to retail investors the kind of financial exposures that they can't usually get that easily. But of course, the downside of that is that the banks are making an awful lot of profit out of that because they get to mark them up a fair bit. So in practice, how these things work is that there's usually a combination of a straight bond, so just a regular bond, and an option of some sort. And so you can see on screen right now a common example of the basic components of a structured product. All of these videos, by the way, are based on my book, which is called Trading and Pricing Financial Derivatives, and I've linked to that in the description below. So if you're kind of following along, if you're trying to learn about derivatives, that might be a good way combined with these videos. But anyhow, often structured products offer what are called principal guarantees to the end investors. What that means is that an investor who invests $1,000 on day one is guaranteed by the issuer to receive their $1,000 back at maturity. Now, of course, since there's no such thing as a free lunch in economics, what this means is that the investor is giving up the interest in their money in the cases where they receive only their initial investment back. So it sort of looks great to people. They put $1,000 in, they get $1,000 back, they claim they didn't lose anything, but of course maybe 10 years have passed and only getting your money back after 10 years isn't really a great return. In a principal guaranteed structured product, with we'll say a 5-year duration, an investor invests $1,000 at inception. The issuing counterparty, which is usually an investment bank, puts that money in a zero coupon bond with a $1,000 payoff at the end of year 5. Zero coupon bonds paying off $1,000 in 5 years will trade at a discount to par. They'll cost less than $1,000 on day one. And the cash differential is the amount that the issuing bank can take a portion of for their fees and use the rest of that to buy options that will hopefully pay off, provide the potential of a payoff to the investor. Now, in the event of the options expiring worthless, the investor receives only their initial $1,000 back, which was financed by the zero coupon bond. In the event of the options expiring in the money, the investor receives their $1,000 investment back, plus whatever the payoff of the option was, minus whatever the fees to the investment bank were over the life of this derivative. So on screen right now, you can see the principal guarantee payoff composition. So what are structures offering investors in exchange for this loss of earning an interest rate on their initial capital investment? Investors put their money in structured products because they like the assurance that they will not have any losses in nominal terms. But under certain economic scenarios, the opportunity to provide significantly better returns. Many kinds of products or risk exposures can be put into the investment package of a structured product or principal guaranteed product. Many structured products have principal guarantees or principal protection. However, not all of them do. A principal guaranteed 5-year note with an initial investment of $1,000 guarantees a minimum return at the end of year 5 of $1,000. This is designed to make an investor feel that in the worst case scenario, no losses are incurred. However, due to the foregone risk-free interest over a 5-year period, the purchasing power of that $1,000 will have been eroded by inflation, and an investor would have been better off having invested at the risk-free rate. The other key risk of principal guaranteed products is counterparty risk, in particular the counterparty that is making the guarantee. In the vast majority of cases, principal guaranteed products are not government-backed guarantees. Instead, they're investment bank-backed guarantees, which come with all of the credit risk relating to those issuers. The options exposures underlying structured products are as varied as the structurer's imaginations. Some of the most popular structured products give investors exposures to the performance of equity, commodities, foreign exchange, interest rates, inflation, and the hedging of corporate risks. Structured products first appeared in the United States, but never really gained wide reception in North America. And this is largely due to consumer protections that require an investor to read and sign an options disclosure document in order to trade or invest in derivative products. In the United States, the OCC, which is the Options Clearing Corporation, issues a 183-page form that's called the Characteristics and Risks of Standardized Options. You can Google that form if you want to see what it looks like. This form is known as the ODD, or Options Disclosure Document. It was first published in 1994, and there's a requirement to sign off on having read and understood this document. And this really just reduces the number of options participants in the United States, because essentially it tells you all of the risks that you're taking, and this scares off unsophisticated investors. And it's really designed to do that. The idea is that people investing in products really understand them and understand the risks that they're taking. Now, in other parts of the world, there isn't this requirement, and these things are just sold to unsophisticated retail investors. And unsophisticated retail investors love things like this. So this much stronger retail customer protection significantly reduced the proliferation of these products in North America. Structured products are widely available in Europe, where 96% of retail structured products are sold, with some of the largest investor bases in Spain and Italy. They're often sold in retail banks as an alternative to savings accounts. Pending European Union rules will soon require banks to inform retail clients what could go wrong with these products. The European Parliament and Council proposed mandatory disclosure to retail investors before they purchase structured products, outlining information on the features far more clearly, stating the bank's structuring fees incurred by the customers, and detailing the risks of structured products. These enhanced disclosures will most likely help consumers to more easily understand and compare products, but equally, like in the United States, it will probably scare quite a few of them away. If you tune into our next video, you can learn all about CPPI, which stands for Constant Proportion Portfolio Insurance, which is a type of structured product. And the week after that, we'll learn about where structured products can go wrong and what kind of fees are embedded in them. Make sure you hit the like and subscribe buttons, and see you next week. Bye.